Amen. Okay. So praise God. Say hallelujah. Are you ready for a special message, as you said? I mean, so I don't, if you don't mind, I know you sat for a long time, but shall we start, bro? We can start? Okay. Okay. Can you stand for another 1 minute? Thank you. Bless you. Shall we just look to Jesus? Lord, we want to thank you for this beautiful evening. Thank you for this, the gift of life. Thank you that your name is above every other name, Lord. Lord, we just pray that you will truly pour your spirit upon each one of us. May your Holy Spirit move in our hearts and move on our minds, Lord. Oh Lord, just come and take complete control of our life. Reveal your plan for us for this new year that you blessed us, Lord. Lord, we want to make sure that this year is better than any other year in our lives, Lord, because you are in control of our lives. You hold our future. You have put within us your Holy Spirit that will reveal to us the plan of God for each one of us, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. We want to bless your name. We want to glorify your name. May your name be praised, Lord. May your name be blessed, Lord. May your name be glorified, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. In the name of the Father, and to the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. 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 Thank you so much. Yeah. Bros, are you okay? You really look as if you're in Andamans, yeah? Yeah, it's okay. Yeah, yeah, very good. I love my people to be close to me. Yeah, that's okay. So how to make 2019 your best year yet? Yeah, that's the teaching. We are still in January, and so we can still speak about the new year. Yeah, it's not so bad. Yeah. So I want to share with you is, look at Isaiah. You know, in Isaiah 43:18-19, forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? And I'm sure you've read this before. There is no one who has not read it, yeah? Because it's a beautiful scripture concerning new beginnings. If you want this new year to be the best year yet in your life, you must follow Isaiah 43:18-19. And Isaiah is actually, in a sense, giving us the way for the year to become good for us. It is putting like a road map in our lives. And if you follow what Isaiah is saying, you and I will make sure that whatever God promises us, it will be accomplished in our lives. Amen. Say hallelujah. So the onus in 2019 is not on God, it's on you. It's on you. Are you willing? Are you willing to follow the Lord? Are you willing to obey His commands? Are you willing to hear His voice? Are you willing to say yes to His will? It's not about God. It's about us. The new year is about us. We can make it or break it. Yeah? So what He says? He says, forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. So point number one, in a sense, here is to say, if you want to 2019 to become the best year yet in your life, we must learn to leave the past behind. Amen? Say hallelujah. You see, the question is, you cannot make progress. We cannot advance in our lives if all the time you keep looking back. Maybe you made a wrong decision. Maybe you put your money in the wrong place. Maybe you married the wrong person. Now too late. But what I'm trying to say is, how can you make, you shouldn't dwell on the past. Don't dwell on the past. I know many, many people, I meet many people across ministry. One of the biggest reasons they just don't advance in their walk with God is all the time they're thinking about the past. They did something, didn't work well. When you dwell on the past, nothing much you can happen in your presence. You know, your present will become very, very bleak because, you know, your mind is still behind. Don't look behind. Never look behind. You know, I don't know if you when you're in your younger days, of course not now, where you were interested in running. Athlete? Have you? None of, look, you did you take part? Amazing. Yeah, really amazing. This is God's miracle looking at you. Yeah, I'm an athlete. You know, I was an athlete simply because I was small and I used to fly. Hey, hallelujah. So it's good to be small also. There are advantages, you know. And you know, when they train you, I was a short distance runner, but the long distance when you run, when they train you, the coach will tell you, when you're running, never look behind. You look behind, you lost the race. You lost the race when you look behind. So in the same way, in a sense, if you keep on looking behind, you will look forward. You will not look forward. The only way to move is to look forward. You know, Philippians chapter 3, 13 and 14, St. Paul is saying, I forget the things that are behind and I look forward to what is ahead of me. Yeah. If you don't have a goal, if you don't have an aim, if you don't have a target, you will become mediocre, whoever you are. You will never move forward. How to move forward? Yeah. So he says, forget the former things, do not dwell on the past. I am doing a new thing. Amen. Say hallelujah. When God says, I am doing new thing, you need to cooperate with the Spirit of God. Then he will do a new thing. It springs up. Do you not perceive it? What a nice word, perceive. Do you not perceive it? Do you not see it? See it? You can only see it if you live a life in the Spirit. You cannot see otherwise. You cannot see the plan of God. You cannot see what God wants you to do. You will not know His will. You will not understand His mind. You will not understand His plan because you cannot perceive it. You can only perceive it when you live a life in the Spirit. Amen? So how? To make 2019 the best year yet, you need to bring a balance. We need to work at a work-life balance. If you work at a work-life balance, you see, this year, you will enjoy life. Yeah? You enjoyed last year? Hello? Yeah? Say nicely. Yeah, yeah. You're not too sure. Yeah? But it will be better. Why? Because every year should become better for us. Yeah? Work-life balance. Let me tell you this. You see, the only way to get the best of the new year is to work towards a healthy work-life balance. Okay? Look at this. Who doesn't know scripture, John 10:10? John 10:10, Jesus is saying, I come that you may have life and life in its fullness. Yeah? Another version says, I come to give you abundant life. I want to ask you this question. You know, what is abundant life? What is the life in fullness? You and I can only enjoy life in fullness, abundant life, life in fullness, only when every area of your life is under the control of the Holy Spirit and you work towards a work-life balance. Then only you will enjoy life in full. Because if there's no balance, then something will take a hit in your life. And when something takes a hit on your life, you will not enjoy life to the full. You will be waiting and saying, Lord, may this year go fast. You will be waiting for the next year. A lot of people are that, no? They wait hoping for the next year. Next year will not make a difference if you don't apply the truth of God. So work-life balance is the fullness of life. That's what I'm saying. If you work at a work-life balance, it is the fullness of life. You know, man's life is like this, isn't it? Man's life is like this. Yeah, physical, mental, emotional, social, professional, spiritual, yeah. So if you want this new year to be the best year yet in your life, what must you do? We know God's Spirit is in control of our life. We know that. That's why you're here. But allow Him to influence every area. You see, Paul, in 1 Corinthians 14:33, right? He tells this. Our God is not a God of disorder, but of order. Amen? Say hallelujah. What does it mean? It means this. Paul is saying, it means this, that when God is there, there is order. When there is disorder, God's presence is not there. So that means order in every area of your life. That's why I put spiritual in the middle. The Holy Spirit is in control of your life. Yeah. Imagine, if the Holy Spirit is not in control of your life, in a sense, what I'm trying to say is, if I am in control of my life, my carnal desires, my carnal life, you know what will happen? Everything will take a hit. Imagine, what will happen to our mental state? Yeah, we will become, in a sense, like, you know, mentally we will not be too sure, we'll be unsound. We won't be able to make the right choices, right decisions. God wants us to go this way, we will go this way. Simply because the Spirit of God is not in control of your life. Imagine, what will happen to our emotions? Can you imagine? Topsy-turvy, right? Emotions will become. Because the Spirit of God is not in control of your emotions. You will struggle to forgive. All the people that you were not in good terms, or whatever, not in good terms, in 2018, you carry forward. Carry forward only works in Bangalore University. If you fail, you can carry forward. But since you should not. Correct, no? Since you should not. Emotional, more stress, more anxiety, more worry, more tension. How many people come to retreats? You know it. How many people come to prayer meetings and they're still caught up in anxiety? Why? Anxiety is a sin according to the Bible, right? Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 and 7, right? Be anxious of nothing. Look at that. Be anxious of nothing. So when the Holy Spirit is in control of your life, you should be anxious of nothing. Tension-free, stress-free, worry-free. That is the Christian life. How many people come for meetings and say, I'm worried about this, worried about that, worried about this? Actually, they don't know what is Christian life. Isn't it? And some people, their nature is like that. Have you noticed? Some people's nature is anxiety. For every little thing, they're anxious. Some people, if they don't have anything to be worried, they're worried. One lady told me to retreat, brother, I have nothing to worry. So I told her, is it good or bad? You see, this is our problem. This is our problem. Our problem is, we are not fully renewed. That's our problem. Fully renewed. 90%, 75%, and that causes actually a conflict. You either be fully renewed or unrenewed, no? That's better actually to live. But when you're not fully renewed, you'll have a problem in life. You will struggle to live the Christian life, emotional life. Look at the social life. If the Spirit of God is not in control of your life, you know what you'll become? You'll become party animal. Yeah, you'll become a party animal. Without party, you'll die. There are people who live only for the weekends, you know? Yeah, because they want that high. They want that high. You cannot get it like that. You'll become party animal. Why? Because the Holy Spirit is not in control of your life. Professional, oh my, professional. You will become workaholic. You will become a workaholic because there is no work-life balance. When there is no work-life balance, mentally you'll be a problem. Emotional, social, professional, physical. How many people are sick today? Yeah, why? Because there is no proper work-life balance. That's why they are sick. Yeah? So we must make sure the Spirit of God is there. We must work towards a work-life balance in our lives. So let's move on. So if you want a good work-life balance, you must fellowship with the Holy Spirit this year more than you ever did in your life. Amen? God's Spirit is more important than anybody else, right? You agree with me? Sure. God's Spirit is in you. He dwells within you. And that's why 2 Corinthians 13 verse 14, may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you. And we know this is St. Paul's greetings. Be with you. Fellowship is what? Friendship. Fellowship is what? Communion. Who is in you? Holy Spirit. Correct, no? You agree with me? Is anybody else in you? You are wondering, right? Sometimes we, Catholics know there are so many others inside. The Holy Spirit is in you, sir. That's the 1 Corinthians 3:16 says, your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. He dwells within you, says the word of God. Look at the scripture, yeah? Dwells within you. Look at this. Romans 8 verse 9. Brothers and sisters, your existence is not in the flesh, but in the Spirit, because the Spirit of God is within you. You did not have the Spirit of Christ, you would not belong to Him. The Spirit of God is where? In you. So if you want this year to become the best year yet, if you want work-life balance, only one person can bring it. It's the Holy Spirit. Because He is a God of order. You are struggling with order. financial order, marriage order, work order. You're struggling. It's all about the Holy Spirit. It's a clear indication. You are lethargic. You're not disciplined. You're indisciplined. You're struggling with punctuality. The Spirit of God is not in control. Yeah. Because where the Holy Spirit is, there is what? Order. There is order. Order means God is there. Order in my life. Order in my money. Order in my finances, marriage, whatever it is. Yeah? Look at this. 1 Corinthians 2:12. We have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit who is from God. So the more, sisters and brothers, this 1 year, let us pray more to the Holy Spirit. Greater intimacy to the Holy Spirit. Greater fellowship with the Holy Spirit. He will revive and renew and transform our lives. Because he is the life giver. The Holy Spirit is the life giver. Yeah. Then order and balance will come into our life. He's a God of order and not disorder. We live a stress-free life. Isn't it? How many people today struggle, right? Stress. So many people. And stress is not only through work, right? Stress can come through anything. The person you're living with can bring stress. What to do? I was preaching at a retreat, and there were a lot of sisters, no? Religious sisters also in this retreat. And I said, look at them. They're so good. If they don't like somebody, no problem. In 3 years, that person will get transferred or you get transferred. Am I right? Hallelujah. And look at us. Married people. Can we get transferred? And if you get transferred, she will come with you, he will come with you. What to do? You can't do much. That's why everything is on the Spirit. It is your life. It is not circumstances. It is not a change. No. It's not saying, when I go there, things will become better. Who said so? Correct, no? When I go to Canada, things will become better. You think so? You will become snowman. Canada, you've been there? Canada? Country doesn't make a difference. State doesn't make a difference. People will not make a difference. Circumstances will not make a difference. You can make the difference. You. You can make the difference. The power of the Spirit is in you to transform you to adapt to situations. Amen. And one of the good prayers to do this year is the three lines. Holy Spirit, I love you. Holy Spirit, be my helper. Holy Spirit, take control of my life. It's an amazing prayer. If you start doing this more and more and more, the Holy Spirit's activity, I call it, yeah? The Holy Spirit's activity will become more and more powerful in your life. Then you'll become sensitive to the voice of God. Then you'll be drawn to the Word of God. And the Word of God will speak to you. Why? Because the Spirit of God is alive. Who is the author of the Bible? Holy Spirit. Correct, no? So some people say, I don't understand it. I said, I'll tell you why you don't understand it. One of the reasons you don't understand the Word of God is the Spirit of God is not active. Because if you know the Spirit, if you fellowship with the Holy Spirit, everything else will fall in place in your life. Amen? Holy Spirit will become alive and, you know, pray in tongues more. This year, you know, I don't know how you feel, you know, some people pray more in tongues. In fact, I wanted to ask Jude's permission to make an announcement, but since it has come, you know, in February 10th, we are running this seminar called Walking in Victory. It's in Cross. Brought it so close to you. February 10th. And if you're not come, please come. Learn. It's all about learning. Never stop learning. What will bring freedom? Learning. Learning will bring freedom. If you don't learn, there you will be. It is knowledge that brings freedom. Learn more and study more, and that is important in our life. Number two, we're talking about work-life balance. You want this good year, yeah? You want this 2019 to be the best year in your life. You must make sure you have some good family life. Most of us are married, right? Yeah, some of you look like, you know, why? But you're married, yeah? Some of you are already looking like, you know, my God, when is this end going to come? Yeah, Lord, either take him or take me soon. And when you pray like that, both don't go. You noticed it? Yeah.
work don't go. Yeah, you know why? Hey, make sure. You see, family life doesn't depend on you, who you marry, what is his status, what job he holds, what car he drives, what is his social status. It doesn't depend on that. Married, good married life depends on God and the spouses. Am I right? This is a sacrament, no? Sacrament. That's why we call it sacrament. Not just, it's not a contract. Marriage is not a contract. If marriage is a contract, then you will look, the way you look. No, it's not a contract. It's a sacrament. What a sacrament? It brings life into you. We say, no, sacraments are what? Sacraments are an encounter with God. Through the sacraments, we encounter God. So we encounter God through the spouse. Amen? Say hallelujah, no? You're looking so terrible. So, good family life just doesn't happen, you know. That's why many people get married with this idea. I'll just get married and everything will happen. Everything will become better. No, it doesn't become better, right? We know, no? You all should do marriage programs for the youth. Before they get married, they must come and talk to one of y'all. Isn't it? Married life just does not happen like that. Who said so? No. Married life does not happen just like that. I tell the couples when I preach to them, the best gift you can give your children is a good married life. Correct, no? Yes. Aim for it. And it's not so difficult. It's not so difficult. Make some quality time. I know you're finished golden jubilee in marriage. Some are hitting platinum. And after that, there is, I don't know what it is. But you can still make sure you have a good married life. Some quality time, some affirmation to your spouses, no? Something good, no? Make sure, because affirmation brings the best out of your spouse. Criticism will kill your spouse. Yeah? Proverbs 18, verse 21. Death and life is in the power of the tongue. You can kill your spouse or bring life to your spouse. Please bring life to your spouse by speaking good, yeah? Be connected with your children. Hey, children come and they go. In the sense, they grow up fast. I know many, many people in ministry today regretting, saying, we never gave much time to our children. You know, we got so caught up with ministry, so busy with ministry, our children just grew up. Lost it. There's a special time. When children are there, it's also a special time. So to make sure you're hitting at a work-life balance. Otherwise, ministry will kill you, no? Ministry should not kill you, no? Yeah? Hello? Yeah. Then you'll be a martyr saint ministry. Yeah. All the full-timers ministry, I'll be praying to you. Saint ministry. He martyred himself. No. That is not what we are saying, yeah? And make sure there's some family prayer. So important, you see, to connect your children. Make sure to pray well. You need to talk to your spouse, you know, if your spouse is not here. But also at the same time is to make family prayer interesting, not boring. Make it 10 minutes. Don't make it too long. My family prayer is 10 minutes. Everybody is there. You say, if you have family prayer, 1 hour. They will have excuses. Yeah, don't make it too long. Some people make it too long and boring. When you open your eyes, only you are there. All are vanished because it's boring. What is more important, what is interesting, make it for them. Yeah. Yeah. That is important for us. Now, some night vigil like going on. My God, don't make it like that. You'll kill it. Make it interesting. You want to pray later on more as a couple, pray. But the children, our youth and all like that today. Yeah, but 10 minutes, 15 minutes. Let them come. Let them pray. Let them read the word of God. Make what is interesting to them. And if you're working, work and studies, make sure you do well. How can you hit work-life balance? 2 Thessalonians chapter 3 verse 10. For even when we were with you, we gave you this rule. The one who is unwilling to work shall not eat. Correct, no? You know what Paul is saying? If you don't work, you don't eat. Correct? So work well. The people who are working, please work well. Make sure you, you professionally do well. You climb the ladder. But there must be a work-life balance. Don't become a workaholic. Don't become a workaholic. God knows how to take you up. Correct, no? Yeah. So you give time for God also, right? Make sure there is enough time for the Lord in the morning to pray, to read the word of God, to connect with a prayer meeting. Yeah. Don't get so busy and then you're gone. Then you're not working for God. Work-life balance will only come when the Holy Spirit is in the center. Don't put him aside. Nothing's going to happen in your life, yeah? Work well, study well. If you're studying, it looks like you're all finished studying long back. There are some, okay. Yeah? Study well. If you're studying, please study well. Make sure you do well in your life. You know, socialize and build relationships. Please, if you want to hit a good work-life balance, enjoy life in it, all its fullness, in all its abundance, socialize. To socialize is not a sin. Jesus socialized. His disciples are only doing adoration. Go to a wedding. Don't feel bad. You see, don't have this ghetto mentality. You know what a ghetto is? I'm only this way. I only like this. I don't go out of my family, my community, my prayer group. Nothing else. Bless you. You live only once, no? Correct, no? Hello? Yes, no? Some of you live twice because it's called Ascension Prayer Group. Yeah. You live only once, sir. Make the best of it. God has to be in the center. Everything will work well in your life. Yeah. Make sure, you know, build relationships, build new. If you don't socialize, let me tell you one thing. If you don't socialize, you cannot make new relationships. You cannot. Yeah? Existing ones make it better. Jesus built relationships. If you read the Gospel of John, chapter 1 to 11, you will find in every chapter, Jesus built relationships. It's amazing. It's only through the relationships Jesus called them to follow him. They followed him and became his disciples. You know that? You know why we don't bring anybody to the prayer meeting? Because we don't fellowship with anybody. We don't socialize. Yeah, that's why we're sitting without anyone. Who to call? I called my husband, he's not coming. Call my wife, she's not coming. Call my children, she's not coming. That's all the world is. Husband, wife, children. Nobody else. Social. If we socialize, you'll be able to call. Share the good news. Social settings are a brilliant place to share the good news. Yeah. And if you don't socialize, then we cannot share the good news. It's very difficult to share the good news. Can you share the good news only to your husband when you go back? Every Tuesday, try. When you're coming home, the door will be locked. He's gone for a walk. He said, my wife is coming. She just finished the prayer meeting, you know. I'll get a dose now. No. That's why you must find places to share the good news, socialize when you travel, etc. Yeah? Hey, do some query. Number point. Some works of charity, right? We need to make some works of charity. There are downtrodden people, the underprivileged people. Yeah. We shouldn't forget them. It's very important, yeah? Widows, parents. I was sharing this at the Logos Night Vigil on the 31st. You know, I was telling them, sometimes we can have a great heart. I was sharing a story with them. This family were in a car, and they were singing this beautiful song, Sharing If We Could Keep Sharing. You know the song, the old Catholic song? You know, beautiful church song, right? Sharing If We Could Keep Sharing. Yeah? It's a very nice song. And they came to a traffic light, and a beggar came, put her hand in. They rolled up the window. When the traffic light became green, they moved and they're singing, sharing, if we could keep sharing, hallelujah. Opportunity came, you did nothing. So it's very important to also know, to make sure we have the poor in our mind too. Then only life can become full. Give alms, right? And don't forget tithing. Yeah? Make sure you give 10%, no? Some of you looking at you can give 25. I mean, look at you, wow. Yeah. Yeah, give 10%. Don't forget your tithing. Yeah, very important to make sure. Then you can live a work-life balance. Yeah, meditate on the Word of God. Many teachings have been given. We're not going into this into detail. But make sure there is time for the scripture and prayer in your life. How can you bring work-life balance if not much prayer is there? 10 minutes. Will 10 minutes do to pray? Hello? There is a saint. His name is Saint Francis de Sales. Have you heard of him? Yeah, amazing saint. Francis de Sales said, every Christian must pray for 30 minutes. If he's very busy, he must pray for 1 hour. You decide. Yeah. You're very busy, pray more, he says. That is important. Why? Because more energy. We need more energy, vitality, passion. It only comes from God. So it's important for us to make this year the best year, to live a work-life balance. Connect with God daily, daily. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. Amen? And read the Word of God daily, you know. And today we know we're all on WhatsApp. Whether you like it or not, all of us get 25 reflections every day, right? Bah, unbelievable. And at least select one, no, which you like. Reflect, no, a little bit. Read the Word of God. My favorite Psalm, Psalm 1, 2 and 3. But they delight in the law of the Lord, meditating on it day and night. You see? And then it says, they are like trees planted along the riverbank, bearing fruit each season. Their leaves never wither, and whatever they do, hallelujah, whatever they do, they will prosper. Why people are not prospering whatever they do? You're not meditating on the Word of God. We are meditating on newspaper, television, but no word. We don't have time for God's Word, you see. At least put it in your mobile phone. Download an audio Bible, no? You're very busy? Download an audio Bible, put it and listen to it. The other day I was going to Chennai. I downloaded the Gospel of Mark, 16 chapters, and I heard it right through the travel. Good, no? Praise God. Don't only listen to music. People only listen to music, music. I'm not against music, but I don't know. Some people only music. I mean, maybe gospel also. You'll go rocking to hell. The Word of God is alive and quick. Yeah. So meditate on it daily. Meditation is important. What is meditation? Meditation is not reading. No, not at your level. You have been coming here for 50 years? Prayer meeting? Yeah? Huh? 50 years? No? 40 years. 40 years you are here. Poof! You should have known every psalm by now. Isn't it? So you need to meditate, not read. Reading will not bring you anything now in this stage. Meditation is to meditate on the Word of God, reflect on the Word of God, ponder on the Word of God, like Mary. You see, she pondered. How beautiful word, isn't it? That is important in our lives, yeah? Last point is to, also to make sure good sacramental life, right? Yeah, especially the sacrament of the Eucharist, sacrament of reconciliation. And don't keep sacrament of reconciliation only for Lent and Easter. Yeah, last minute. Somehow we want to go. No, don't make it. Make it a habit to go once a month. Make it a habit. Take your children with you. Make it a family time. When we go for confession, all of us go. Collectively, as a family. Yeah, everybody. It's important. So that the children also learn it, right? And if possible, I don't know for you how it is, you know, but if it is possible to have a personal confessor, go to the same priest, how nice, no? Imagine if you and I can go to the same priest for confession. Wow. Amazing, no? Two things will happen. Either he will change or you will change. You try, no? It's important, but no? It brings accountability, right? Imagine going to the same priest, brings accountability. He will tell you one day, you're coming to me with the same sin. Same sin. And we love it. Sometimes we, Catholics, we have something called recycle our sins. Every confession, they come back like this. Make sure it doesn't happen, right? Kill it, no? You can do it. You can kill it. I have a same confessor so that you become accountable, and then the light and then the freedom of the Lord will come in your life. So, Colin Wright said, you have exactly one life in which to do everything you will ever do. Act accordingly. What we should do? Act on it. See your life. Make sure it brings balance. Don't go for an imbalance. No, don't do that. Yeah? It will only create a problem in some other area of your life. Colin Powell said, a dream doesn't become a reality through magic. It takes sweat, determination, and hard work. But for us, it is much easier. You know why? Because God has given us the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. You don't have to sweat so much. You will sweat when you work outside the Holy Spirit. You'll sweat. So what is important is God has blessed you and me with the Holy Spirit. And so this year, sisters and brothers, make sure you enjoy life to the full. Abundant life that can only happen through a work-life balance. If you have work-life balance, everything will fall in place for you and you will be enjoying life. Believe that the Holy Spirit is going to do new things. Perceive it. Hope for it. Hope is important, isn't it? Yeah, hope for it. Make sure, confess it, declare that this year will be your best year. Amen. Amen. This year will be your best year when it comes to finances, marriage, health, whatever it is. No? Confess it. Believe it. Because it's the promise of God. Promise of God. And Isaiah 43 verse, we already saw this, 18 and 19, and bring this work-life fellowship with the Holy Spirit. Every day. And I'm telling you, it will add life to you. You will never age. Amen? Yeah. You will never age. Why? Because the Spirit, it brings life. Amen? He brings life. He doesn't bring death. He brings life. More energy, more zeal. Some people say, this person's an enthu cutlet. Have you heard of it? Enthu cutlet? Yeah, it'll make you something. Enthu bonda. But that's the power of the Holy Spirit. You know, laid back, dead, everything is gone. This fella's useless. She is useless. Mother-in-law's useless. Everybody's useless. Waiting for the Lord to come again. Hare Baba. Make life better. It's in your hands. Amen. Yeah. Forget the things that are behind. Press on to the things that are in front of you. Forward. Put a goal. Have a name. And then it will bring an amazing work-life balance in your life. Study well. Socialize. Work of charity. Meditate on the word of God. More life. And this year, the Holy Spirit will take complete control. Then what will happen is, as St. Paul says, you and I will start living a Spirit-controlled life. And the Spirit-controlled life is the life of a Christian. Amen? Say hallelujah. Please stand. Sisters and brothers, as we look to Jesus, let's pray and say, Lord, give us this desire, the desire to hit a good, healthy work-life balance, not to go off on a tangent. Help us, Lord, to enjoy life in its fullness, abundant life. Pray to the Holy Spirit, the God that dwells within us, that He'll bring more order in our lives. Remove confusion, chaos, disorder. Let's raise our hands to Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Praise your name. Bless your name, Lord. Kuravana shanda manana 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 mani. Gona vana shanda manana 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 mani. Gona vana shanda manana manana manana. Hallelujah, Lord. Oh, we praise you. May your name be blessed, Lord. May your name be glorified, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Bless you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Mary, your mother, you pondered on Scripture. You were open to the will of the Father. You went with haste to Elizabeth. Mother, during this year, intercede for each one of us. Give us this ability to desire and to do the will of God in everything that we do. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In the name of the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Amen. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless you. Thank you so much.